just to see. All right, I really hope they fix the ban thing. Like they actually start banning the right champions.
No, he's the captain. He's
I like the icon synergy. They've got really nice icon synergy here across the board.
They did last game. Not so much.
Yeah, I think they mix it up. But Pew is dropping the ball.
Okay, well they didn't need us, so we're getting right into it, into the client.
Right.
So they've switched sides again. Oh, did we update the score?
Yes. Not on this, on the in-game one though.
All right.
We'll update that.
Well, what if it doesn't let us alt tab?
Well, we'll do it while it's in the second period. Yeah.
Okay.
The 3 minute.
All right.
Anyway, the Tristana ban coming out finally.
Immediately.
Thank God.
Tired of that. Nisha, please.
I think that was mandatory, and I'm kind of upset that it took them this third game to actually be able to catch all this and learn it.
For sure. And Fiddlesticks going to be banned against Team Fiddlesticks. They are not even going to bother letting them do it. Udyr going to get banned out for Tree Stump. So Team Fiddlesticks clearly just banning based on last game. So.
Yeah, they're learning their lesson. Mm-hmm. And wow, completely taking out Tristump from his jungling picks.
He has some other picks. I want to see if he picks them, but
he probably should.
Yeah, we'll see. Yeah, someone in the crowd just pointed out there hasn't been a Morgana ban this time. There's the Warwick ban, so now Tree Stump is low on junglers. Well, they banned out Warwick, so I guess he doesn't actually care about Warwick. So let's see what Pew Pew is going to take first. Probably Xin Zhao, if he was confident in last game. Are we not streaming? Is this stream on?
We're getting zero transmitted.
There we go. It just came back.
Yeah, it's really low, though.
All right, now it's fine.
All right. Sorry, temporarily dealing with some internet connectivity problems. But first pick going out to Orianna. Super safe. We've seen great success with her in the past few games.
But now she's on the other team. This is Sergeant Cran who's going to be rocking
That's
Orianna.
That's true, and usually he decides to go for that Syndra pick to counter Orianna. How's it looking?
It's probably just going to drop frames. Someone just make sure the stream's not dying. Anyway, the counter pick jungler this time is going to be Nunu. So Tree Stump going to go ahead and rock a Nunu. And Nija, please, looks like he's going to lock in that Zyra for RX Yamen. So no AD carry as of yet.
Yeah, so we're seeing the triple Zyra support games. Already seen great success on RX Yamen on Zyra. However, the Nunu pick is really unique, and I haven't seen Nunu that much, especially, and I'm really curious to see how he's going to do in the current meta. But the fact of the matter is his snowball is an automatic slow, which is applied, which would have a great combo with all of Zyra's CC abilities. So they could utilize that to great success during ganks in the bottom lane.
Yeah, I really am excited to see what they end up doing with this Nunu. Meanwhile, on the other side of the team, we've got Yonly Legs once, might be pulling up in that Graze again, with Leona run by Sick Grime. So that was a lane that was pretty successful in game one, at least more successful than Corgi Janna.
But they still struggled. They got completely outpoked by the combination of Tristana and Zyra, which are two champs which really utilize their long range to be able to whittle down their opponents. And last time, Leona and Graves were not able to engage properly. Inept for the third time in a row, mousing over that Yasuo, trying to make his decision.
Yeah, I think he's just going to show it every time. Yeah. Caitlyn, I'm actually not surprised to see from Nisha, please. He really likes attack speed focused junglers. Tristana and Caitlyn are maybe his two top that he was talking about before the set began. So seeing Caitlyn, this will be really interesting. Still has a poke lane, still does a lot of damage. Karma coming out for Inept to deal with the Orianna from Sergeant Crane.
Karma is a champion that can deal a lot of damage and have great amount of survivability with her shields and her movement speed, but she's very difficult to play, and she does have a hard time because a lot of her abilities are very short range. So that countered with Orianna's incredibly long range with all of her command moves could be a very difficult mid lane.
And let's see what the final picks are going to be here. For Team Fiddlesticks, we might see Irelia again for Wugong, his favorite character in the top lane. And Sergeant Cran is going to grab the jungler for Pew Pew. And that decision will be interesting, especially because you don't want to get counter-jungled by Nunu this time around, because Nunu can just come in and consume steal stuff. That's sort of what Nunu does really well. And now that you can get so many cool bonuses from the new jungle camps, that's going to be really interesting. Kha'Zix looks like it's going to be the jungler of choice for Pew Pew. It's going to be interesting because that's sort of a last season jungler. We haven't seen much Kha'Zix in preseason 5.
Kha'Zix actually works really well with someone like Leona, who can lock down his opponents for him and allow him to jump and get those resets. So maybe Tristana won't be in this game to be able to get her resets, but at least Kha'Zix certainly will.
Yeah, every game apparently during this Grand Finals has to have some amount of jumps. So.
Okay.
Final pick coming up from Jadamus. Now this is actually going to be the top lane unless he's going top lane Karma. Yeah, so we're going to see top lane Lulu. So 3 AP carries and Caitlyn and a Nunu. A really wonky team comp, honestly.
But yeah, it's I suppose it's very long range, although they're following a similar format of having one main tank and 4 utility focused champions.
Yeah.
With the exception of the AD carry, who of course is damage focused. But we saw a previous match like this where Caitlyn was replaced with Tristana and Nunu was replaced by Udyr. Very similar champion, someone who locks down a single target, has a lot of movement speed buffs for himself or his allies. And they have the exact same composition relatively. So we know they're able to utilize that to great success previously. I want to see if they're able to replicate this.
And that's, the other thing is it's still shield heavy. Inept, you know, now that he's got Karma, he can drop the shields, he can drop giant shields, and Jadamus still has the wild growth and shield.
Exactly.
So that still exists. I'm going to switch to this real quick and fix the score. It's going to be this one.
Yep.
There we go. Fixed. All right. Back to the client.
Let's go monitor capture. Let's try to get that...
That what?
Law Nexus in.
Oh, yeah, of course. So switching right on over. And here we go. So we've got, see, anything issues. Let's start with the bottom lane. Basically exactly what we've seen all day. Leona with these defensive masteries going to be very tanky. Graves going for super offense. Zyra getting that poke. Lots of damage from Caitlyn. Again, plus 1 mana regen per 5.
Because
you definitely need that.
Well, now Caitlyn needs the hops.
I guess
she
so.
She needs the resets.
She needs the resets. She doesn't get resets. That's not how that works. I want to make sure it's not like a stream issue. Okay. So at any rate, we've got also the top lane matchup. They've both grabbed Teleport again. This is exactly what we saw in game
right.
one. He actually didn't go the offensive Irelia where he went 17-12-1. This time he goes 7-21-2. So he switched up his Irelia playstyle for this match. Meanwhile, Lulu still doing Lulu stuff.
Yeah, something that's really interesting to me is that Nunu is packing 0-9-21. He's opting to go not as defensive as the majority of Nunu's go, where they go 0-21-9. He's going a lot more utility, so cooldown on his buffs. I'm guessing this is a kank, a gank-heavy Nunu. And we know Tristump loves ganking. He played Udyr, he played Lee Sin, both very aggressive junglers. And Nunu can either be an aggressive or a defensive jungler. Like, he can focus on farming or getting those global objectives or transitioning into the mid-game teamfight stage. But we're going to see a lot of ganks from Nunu very early on.
And so the final thing we can talk about is this mid lane fight, and that's going to be Orianna. This is now being played by Sergeant Cran, still going 21-09. Karma, on the other hand, getting just straight up AP to start off, which is very interesting against an Orianna who can play defensive if she needs to.
I'm expecting the a lot of health potions coming out from Orianna. She's probably going to go for the Rejuvenating Bead, get that sustain out, because Karma really, she's very mana heavy. And she's not going to have the same amount of wave clear or straight-up kill potential as Orianna does. And on top of that, she's packing Barrier, which I think is a really interesting choice, especially for a mid laner. But we've seen that Inept likes to run those non-aggressive summoner spells in order to sustain and transition through his lane.
All right, so let's go ahead and we got 30 seconds left, so we can get ready for this game. Real quick, talk about the summoner spells. I think Inept actually, yeah, you were just talking about Barrier. That's just so weird against an Ignite, but it might actually save his life in the end. And he can drop Barrier when he's dropping a shield on someone else during a team fight, which will also be very helpful.
Mm-hmm.
Aside from that, the summoners are about the same. Both supports grabbed Exhaust. Both AD carries brought Heal. So it should be pretty mirrored as we get into this game.
All right. Well, we got just 1 second left, but we are now transitioning into Game 3.
There we go.
Of our Capital One Grand Finals circuit.
Yeah, shout outs to Capital One for sponsoring this tournament. The winner of this tournament gets $1,000 as supplied by Capital One.
Well, not $1,000. It's $1,000 prize pool for the tournament. But both teams have been competing over the past 4 weeks thanks to Capital One sponsorship.
Check out how the overlay is like cutting off Irelia's head.
A sign of things to come for Irelia, indeed. The threats coming out.
Look, Oriana's just like, excuse me, you're invading my picture.
Fiddle, Graves just getting face planted by the side.
That's wonderful. All right. So Inept doesn't seem to have connected.
Yeah, we are all playing locally at the Capital One facility. So both teams are here live. Facility, office. They have multiple locations.
The Capital One factory. Like
Capital One domestic home. Uh-oh, Pew Pew correcting his icon. Mistake from earlier.
Oh, good. Yeah, so they all have the same icon. That's important. You want your team to all have the same icon so you know that you're a team together.
Global dynamic synergy is very important for each team.
Shoutouts to Team Fiddlesticks. It's very spooky.
They're owls. Are those owls?
They're,
They look like owls.
They're faces. They're crowns.
Yeah, but they look like owls.
They're crowns that go on the faces of owls.
No, I see you.
No, you don't. I'm invisible.
Please.
Dude, if Inept could load faster, we could actually have an awesome comedic timing transition into this match. There's a great one of the Smash Bros. YouTube videos. He edits like when they start and stop, right? So we edit it so that it cut off right in the middle of a commentator conversation, and he goes, "Yeah, but I have to stay in the closet. I mean, I'm only an actor." Anyway, getting into this match. I'm gonna adjust this.
Anyway, we're going into game 3 of the Capital One circuit. And so far, the score is 2-0 in favor of Team Black Dynamite, with Team Fiddlesticks struggling to get past the consistent tankiness and CC utility.
Fountain has a health bar. Oh, no, it's gone now.
Oh.
It did. Oh, did he not connect? Yeah, someone didn't connect.
I think there might be some connectivity issues. But we're in game 3. We've seen that Team Fiddlesticks is really struggling to get past that front line and that utility lockdown of Team Black Dynamite. And I don't know if they'll be able to properly learn and transition coming into Game 3, but I really hope they actually have learned their lesson.
And we'll see what happens as we wait for someone to connect. I believe it was Graves. Yep, there it is.
Good call. You know. You were informed.
Oh, look at all the things I can do with the vision. Oh, there they are. There they are. There they're not. There they are. Oh. So much excitement.
Anyway, we've got 2 seconds left for play, and I don't know. Now, let's talk about the very, very early game. Are we going to see an invade from either team?
I just saw Purple Side ping the bottom turret, and it looks like they're heading right over there. Meanwhile, the line of scrimmage coming out from blue team here. So they're all going to spread out and try and make sure they get wards down as soon as possible. Purple Side looking like they're trying to get into this try, but with the home guard, Irelia is actually going to get down here first. Now, that's actually key that this is Irelia.
Oh, but she might not be able to spot it because
she didn't drop a ward. She forgot her trinket.
Oh, my God. That could be a critical mistake.
That's huge because here comes Kha'Zix. He sees it. Are they going to get him? There's the snare.
Oh!
Are they going to get the slope? He's going to force the flash the wall. How unfortunate. That is the one time you don't want to forget your trinket.
Oh my God, that could have been much, much worse than just a blown flash, though.
Yep.
And right now, forgetting your trinket isn't that big of a deal, but what it shows is that right now, Team Fiddlesticks is not coordinated. They're unnerved by the first 2 games. They're not on top of their game. Forgetting a trinket means that they're not ready, and WGong needs to get his head in the game. Because otherwise, we're seeing it's already causing negative things for Team Fiddlesticks.
Now, that's the one important thing is that they didn't see this lane swap that's coming through. They're sending Irelia to the bottom lane. Graves and Leona will be in the top lane against Lulu.
There's a ward in the bottom lane. It might spot them if Irelia just takes a couple steps out because they do have vision of this area, but it also is a trinket ward, so it's going to run out in just a few seconds.
So Lulu now sees that Graves and Leona are top lane, so they are 100% aware that this is going to be a lane swap.
But Lulu can wave clear, and she can farm much better than Irelia can. WGong is going to be suffering. so hard in this solo lane against Zyra and Caitlyn. Because both of those champions have so much long-range poke, Aurelia's not going to be able to farm, and she's going to get continuously shut down and prevented from sustaining.
Oh, she does have that Q where she can jump in and grab a minion and head right on out. And looks like that's going to be her strategy. Meanwhile, Lulu has a bit of range in order to deal with Graves and Leona, so she can sort of farm from long range. There she goes, even getting another minion right there. Oh, she actually didn't get that minion. She whiffed it completely. Meanwhile, we have both Kha'Zix and Nunu grabbing their respective buffs. Oh my god.
Uh-oh, Pew Pew getting dangerously close, just trying to take the red buff. It's going to kill. Oh my god, it's going to be down to just one Ajahn. Is he able to finish off ADS?
Yeah, that Krug buff is going to help him stun the red buff and help him finish it. Now it looks like he's going to go back. Meanwhile, Nunu, with that insane sustain he gets from Consume, is just going to grab his own buff and continue to jungle effectively.
Yeah, when a Nunu auto-attacks a few times, his passive enables his next spell to be absolutely free of mana cost.
Whoa, look at the damage! The burst, can he finish it? There's first blood with the flash! Yomi legs once. Showing Jadamus who's boss, they're going to take that first kill, and Graves is already off to a good start.
Sick Grimes having the perfect initiation there. He knew to jump onto Jadamus, as Jadamus was not able to respond there. And that continuous aggression, as Jadamus has been forced to blow his teleport, could prove vital for this lane swap success.
Exactly. We now see Kha'Zix grabbing his own blue buff. After all of that, he was forced to go back and finally get a really late buff. Nunu's actually coming in for an invade, possibly, or he's just going to go ahead and grab the crab, using that raptor buff to show that there's no wards that spotted him. He can take it for free. Really smart.
WGog taking, like I said, a lot of that poke. He's down to half health already. Although Inept is doing a great job duking it back and forth with Sergeant Crayon, forcing those pots to already fall.
Oh, what a flash! Oh. And they're going to go in on Sergeant Crayon. The slow comes out. He expected a flash. He's going to get it late. And luckily, Pew Pew is in the region to help out Sergeant Crayon and escape.
That was aggressive, but I think that was overly aggressive, because now Tristram splashes down and he got absolutely nothing out of that. I think he had plenty of time to just finish walking around and manually start auto-attacking and forcing Sergeant Crayon to blow his flash without his own going down.
Continuing to see Jadamus take this harass damage from this Leona Graves lane. Now, while they're not exactly a poke-heavy lane like Zyra and Caitlyn, luckily, you know, if she gets engaged on, Leona can just sort of destroy Jadamus, and that's something they need to be wary of for a while.
I'm half expecting, just because Tristram is in the area, to see a possible tower dive onto WGog. We saw, actually, in a previous tournament game that Team Black Dynamite likes going for those even level 3 tower dives. They're insane when it comes to aggression, and they're really, really good at it. So now Tristram's in the area. He's great on health. He's a very tanky champion innately. I want to see that tower dive.
Well, right now, they're actually putting a lot of damage onto the tower. It's like they don't even need Nunu to come through. Another wave of minions might actually help them secure this tower. Meanwhile, Nunu's actually going to head to the mid lane. No, Kha'Zix is on his way down bot. Nunu's going to go ahead and do some counter jungling as well.
Actually, Nunu and Kha'Zix might run into each other here, and we'll see if they're going to be able to duke it out.
Here we go.
Spot each other.
Tristram says hi. He might have just actually stolen that with Smite. There's more auto attacks. The red buff is actually saving Tristram here. Little bit of a juke into the brush, and he's going to get away.
Yeah, Aurelia is in no position to help him whatsoever, and Aurelia needs to back and teleport right back in before the tower falls, because I think Caitlyn and Zyra might be able to actually push the tower down.
And we'll see that in just a second.
Especially with the Nunu Blood Boil.
Yeah, they're pushing down the minions. Here comes the teleport. How quickly can they do it? Can they actually do it and then end up killing Irelia? Irelia actually stands on a trap, so that's going to force Neja Please to take a tower shot. And now the game has been paused. Let's go ahead and check the chat. More lag. People complaining about lag right as there's a... Oh, Leona disconnected in the top lane, as you can see on your minimap here. Just sort of standing there.
Quite unfortunate.
Just going to have to hang out for a little bit. Like to point out that Orianna actually went back, and we can talk a little bit about the items. Orianna got a second Doran's Ring to the chalice that Inept has. So Inept is a pretty far ahead. In the jungle, Kha'Zix already grabbing the Trailblazer. That means it's a farming item. He gets AoE from Smite.
Right.
And he's also probably going to end up getting Devourer on top of that, so he can get those essentially those Feral Flare stacks and go back in. The reconnect is live, so we're going to jump back into this tower situation we've got in the bottom lane.
The tower's about to fall, and WGog has got to book it out of there. He is not going to stop this tower from falling in any way, shape, or form. That is 150 gold for each member of Team Black Dynamite.
Exactly, and they're going to just walk on out of there for free and continue to farm up on Ninja Please. Now, if Ninja Please gets big, he'll continue to be a threat like he's in every game. Oh my goodness, oh. W Gong, realizing that Zyra is gone, they're going to actually snare him down. There's the exhaust. Treestone comes in with the snowball. Is she going to try and turn around on Ninja Please? Because she doesn't have a tower here anymore. The flash comes through. The blood boil, so strong. The slow comes out with the snowball again. A nice stun. Can they finish her? No! Here comes Kha'Zix! Kha'Zix tries to turn around. Ninja Please is going to go down, but so is Irelia. Now it's uh-oh, Pew Pew against the world. Karma is here. Are they going to try and chase him down? He's going trying to go the other way. And this might be it. It's so hard to catch these characters.
Sergeant Crayon is nowhere in sight, but there's no mana left. Oh, the Jukes!
The Jukes is gonna get it!
Oh my god!
The snowball
almost falling, having just a little bit of health remaining as a result of that gank. But oh, Pupa did a nice job reversing and jumping on to finish. Nice, please. But we're seeing that W Gong is underestimating his own, or overestimating his own burst potential, even against a very squishy target like Caitlyn.
And we can also point out that in the top lane, Jadamus has now hit level 6, so it's going to be almost impossible to dive onto him anymore with Leona Graves. So, and he's been farming pretty well comparatively. So this is Team Black Dynamite continuing to take early advantages in these games.
I mean, Jadamus has that long range. He has that wave clear. And I kind of want W Gong here to freeze the laning even maybe for a little bit. Irelia is a champion that's very reliant on farm. She needs a lot of minion kills and a lot of gold in order to be able to do her job properly, which is to be a tanky fighter. And she's behind on gold right now.
Whoa! From Sergeant Crayon, will it be enough? No, the shield just comes out. Inept is actually not even going to flash or anything, just going to walk away. Barrier not even used, but he's at very low health. He's going to go ahead and back off.
It's 2-2 right now. 1,000 gold difference in favor of Team Fiddlesticks, but for Team Black Dynamite, but the tower falls. Jadamus falling about half health. Sunlight passive procced, but not enough damage to be able to finish him off anyway.
And Graves is actually getting incredibly low. We've got an engage here onto Sergeant Crayon in the mid lane as well, but he needs to land a snare. It looks like he's not going to get it. Inept still just hanging around with, like, no health. Meanwhile, on the bottom lane, I mean, W Gong has somehow frozen the lane with, like, a giant wave in front of him the entire time. Like, he hasn't moved it.
But T-Black Dynamite might be true. Oh my god, they finish off Lulu with a great engage but by Sick Grimes. But unfortunately, in counter, Team Black Dynamite is going to go after the dragon, and I don't see any sort of opposition from Team Fiddlesticks here. That's going to be free dragon pickup at the 8-minute mark.
And there it goes, the bonus damage now coming through for Team Black Dynamite. They're willing to sacrifice Jadamus in the top lane for that. They had already lost that turret. Oh my god, really?
You have to watch the Scuttled Crab fall.
I got it.
But yes, they're now sitting very far at one. Yeah, there you go.
Yay!
Anyway, Team Black Dynamite did a nice job there where they saw that both of the Graves and Leona were still stuck in the top lane because they didn't manage to push down that turret. And Team Black Dynamite rushed down the bottom lane turret as a result of the lane swap in order to secure Dragon. And that's why I think this whole lane swap operation is a very risky business and they haven't been able to capitalize on it just yet.
Well, look at the farm in the bottom lane. Irelia has now actually brought it all the way back. 47 farm. She's actually starting to out-farm some of the, you know, more well-farmed members of the enemy team. And that's going to be impressive if she can actually bring back that farm disadvantage so hard.
Yeah, she's been farming almost perfectly since she's been able to freeze that lane. And now Lulu comes here, but Lulu is sitting at 0-2 and is down 20 farm compared to Irelia. She's not able to be able to stand up in these fights at all.
To mention, up in the top lane, we see Arxiaman and Ninja Please going to try and force down this top lane tower. Inept is the only one left here to defend against this, and there are three members of Blue Team going to try and force this down. Even Kha'Zix can come up to support if he needs to. And this should be a tower for Blue Side. Team Fiddlesticks will grab this.
Right, Team Fiddlesticks actually had a very nice gold advantage because they are up a kill at this point. They are up in towers as well. Despite Black Dynamite just now bringing it back with that top lane tower kill. However, Irelia, look at Irelia, you're right, she's now at 59 farm, second highest when you compare to Team Black Dynamite, and a fed Irelia is incredibly difficult to take care of.
As you see, Lulu, being incredibly smart, needed to get out of there at that very moment because the entire team was coming down to get her. Oh, we got Orianna a little bit caught here. Is she going to try and force Ninja Please out? Ooh, a little bit of damage here and there. Vine's coming in to slow Sergeant Crayon down a little bit, but not a lot of damage actually being shown from Team Black Dynamite. You know, Nunu snowballs don't really do that much. He ended up going for Poacher's Knife, which means he's going to be farming a lot more and grabbing a little bit more gold with his farming in the jungle.
Well, so Sergeant Crayon is doing a great job utilizing that Command Protect to enable him to continuously shield off any damage. And on top of that, he's been moving very well. His actual positioning, where he's dodging the snares, anticipating the slows from Nunu, being able to dodge the abilities as he goes back to his own tower.
Whoa, that shockwave onto Nija, please! He's gonna flash away from the ult, but it's not gonna matter. Nija, please, is actually staying alive. Just barely want to knock up the exhaust. Can he get away? No. He tries to put in another auto attack. Just how about his team? They're gonna turn around and grab Kha'Zix. The damage from Inept, too good. And Inept trying to go back in, but W Gong is gonna scare him off.
Inept is laying down a huge amount of damage. He's 2-0-1 with 64, but he's able to burst by utilizing that Karma Mantra for maximum damage. And we're seeing that right now, Team Fiddlesticks has a great job where they're able to burst out people. Like, they're turning on to RX Jam, and WGong laying down his true damage in response, laying down the ultimate finish off the low health Zyra. She's not even going to bother firing off her ultimate, her passive.
There it goes. It hit no one, but
yeah.
Yeah, she got super caught out, and she really didn't want to be there. And the team can't really support her at this time. When we're talking about how good their team fight potential is, their pick potential just seems useless right now. I mean, Karma just has a chalice. Nunu does not have any damage items built at all. Everything is just for farming or for tankiness, and Caitlyn needs to wait until the late game to get big. So the bottom lane turret's gonna go down. They really need to get to this late mid game team fight potential that their characters have. But they need the itemization to do it.
Right. Something that I'm really liking about Team Fiddlesticks in this game, though, is the previous two games, we continuously ran into the scenario where Team Black Dynamite had this great team fight, and all Team Fiddlesticks could do in response was try and get a pick. Now they're getting those picks before the team fight even becomes a problem. They're actually capitalizing on the small mistakes that Team Black Dynamite is doing, and they're catching them out of position.
Here we go. Just a little bit of skirmish between the two sides. Nunu, at least he's being incredibly tanky with this build he's got right now, you know. His consume still does a lot, so he's free to farm and get big over the course of the rest of the match. And he will get bonus gold from smiting enemy camps, or smiting camps. Let's see here. An enemy camp, sorry.
Oh, the Poacher's Knife.
Yep. That's basically your counter jungling jungle item, where you get bonus gold and a little bit of move speed.
And that matches up with Tristram's playstyle, who really prefers playing the aggressive jungler. We're seeing that OOPPU likes more of the situational aggressive jungler. He doesn't frequently end up in the other jungle trying to catch the other jungler out of position.
Right.
He's usually more of a response type player, and that has been hurting them in these last few games, because instead of being the playmaker, he's the reactioner.
Seeing purple team making their way up to the mid lane. Zyra and Caitlyn dropping wards as they make their way up here. Graves just gonna back off. So we've got a very safe playstyle from both teams right now. Team Black Dynamite knows that they can't really afford to take fights anymore. So it's a lot less exciting than games 1 and 2 because they don't have the lead anymore and they have to stay back and play safe.
Right, but on top of that, you know that Team Fiddlesticks has to be very nervous right now. They're down 0-2 one more game. That's the end of the best of 5. And as both teams gear up for Dragon in just 9 seconds, this could be all on the line right now.
Aurelius
as the teamfight will really strongly
decide
the fight.
Here comes Dragon. He's going to do its little animation. Red team hanging out. Here comes a teleport in. Oh no, Jadamus is actually teleporting away. I don't know if that's the best decision. No, he's just teleporting in place. Yeah, weird decision. Irelia is going to continue pushing that tower as we might have a fight breaking out right now. They're continuing to force the rest of blue team away. And now they're actually all forced to leave. RX Yamin is backing in a really weird spot.
Jadamus took a lot of auto attack damage from Dragon just from those few hits. And I really want to see Team Fiddlesticks right now grouping up for this Dragon as Karma is forced to go top and Irelia still has her teleport available.
Here they go. They're trying to do it again. This time it's a 4v4 until Irelia comes in. But Karma is... Oh, what a beautiful ult from Liana. Here comes the shockwave. Oh my god, the damage is so crazy. Insta triple kill from Graze. The AoE comp gets them that dragon.
What? That was absurd. The most perfect Liana ultimate I have seen in a very long time. And the combination from the Graves buckshot, just dealing so much AoE damage immediately, followed by the command shockwave. That was the perfect way to play. We keep talking about how Liona and Graves has this great all-in and engage potential. And when those kind of team fights happen, team Black Dynamite just gets decimated.
Yep.
And the Dragon pick up on top of that, and they're likely going to be able to push down this hurt, but no, they're actually going to back just in case. Playing it safe, doing the smart option there. But by God, the AoE Wombo combo has been doing wonders for them.
Yeah, that was absolutely absurd, and that's going to put both teams even on Dragons. So both of them have the 8% bonus in damage, and they're going to hopefully, I mean, now that it's even, Team Fiddlesticks can take team fights anytime they want. It already looked like they were taking any team fight they wanted, because the team fight potential from Team Black Dynamite is just not strong right now. They don't do enough damage. Caitlyn has yet to finish her Infinity Edge. Graves has an Infinity Edge and a Zeal. Triple kill will get you whatever you want. He's 5-0 right now.
The 5-0, and the thing about that is that he's a 5-0. That happens sometimes. I don't know what it is. But the 5-0, he's fed, but you cannot disregard the rest of a team. Irelia has her Trinity Force. Kha'Zix already deals so much damage just by jumping in and laying out that utility, the slow, the isolation damage, all of that. Orianna 0-0 and 5, but she's got the Unholy Grail. Even though Graves is the primary target, the rest of the team is devastating. And that makes Team Black Dynamite's job really difficult, because they don't have a super clear focus target, as both of their top laner and their AD carry are in a negative KDA right now.
And there we go. They might have even caught out Jadamus. The Shockwave is used. A great flash from Jadamus to avoid it.
A little bit aggressive from both teams, but now blue team is in a great position. Oh,
here come the Stranglethorns. They might have caught out Sergeant Cran. Jadamus is trying to go in. Not enough damage. The Polymorph comes through. That's going to do it. Nisha, please, has shown up to try and help take this fight to the next level. The beautiful Leona ult. It's actually going to be a nice disengage. Can they catch up to the rest of Team Fiddlesticks? Graves and Irelia have nowhere to go. The cloud from Graves might have been enough, but here we go. They're trying to chase down onto Sick Grimes. Here comes the ult from Treesome. He's going to slow a lot of them down. He's not going to get stunned. Explosion onto Sick Grimes. He's going to go down. RX Ammon is getting so low from Pew Pew. Pew Pew is going to be forced to flash away. Ninja Blaze is so low. The invisibility, he's going to get a kill as well. And next is going to turn it around. W Gong is still going. Treesome is going to fall. Graves has been doing so much damage in the back. And it's two left for both teams. And that was an intense fight.
Team Fiddlesticks with the great reversal. They knew they were in a position where they would either get picked off one by one and completely annihilated, or they could turn that around for the kill. And that's exactly what they did. Leona even knew she wasn't getting out of the new absolute zero ultimate. And she said, you know what? I'm going back in. I'm going to blow up this Lulu. And only RX Jam got out of there with just a little bit of health. Along, even the very tanky Nunu fell, and that's what you do, you reverse fights. And I was really worried there that Team Fiddlesticks was actually going to just be caught out and decimated, because they have a problem with that in general. Like, Sergeant Crayon fell at the very beginning of the fight just by being out of position. But reversing that, coordinating with their team, having every member go, yes, we're doing this now, all in, this is exactly what Team Fiddlesticks needs to come back in this tournament.
And here's the thing, both teams are now having to switch up their style. Team Black Dynamite normally gets Ninja Please fed, and they try to defend him. Now it's Inept who's big. Inept who's going to be fed. Inept is going to be their number one damage dealer. On the other side of the map, the exact opposite. Last game we saw Sergeant Cran get big. Didn't work too well for them. Now they've got Graves getting huge. You Only Legs Once is now their big damage dealer. Let's see how they can defend him going forward.
Exactly. And the thing about I'm so happy they banned out the Tristana.
Right.
Because the Tristana man on Nyx Please is able to utilize Tristana all the time and is able to hop and continuously stay in the back line. But Caitlyn, despite her long range, only has one displacement to Broplex Saber. And it looks like Team Black Dynamite might be trying to rush down Baron as soon as it spawns at the 20-minute mark.
Yeah, they're all here. And, I mean, Graves is bot. They actually can't stop this. Here they go, they're gonna start chipping it away. There's no vision on this at all. They have no idea. So they could just do it. Here we go, the rest of blue team is actually picked up on a Sick Grimes. It's being caught up. There comes the ult. The Shockwave only lands on Treesome. That's a huge blow to their team fight potential right now.
But they stopped the Baron. They stopped the Baron with just two members, and that was crucial. Because that was a very sneaky attempt by Team Black Dynamite, but it cost them time. And they're not at an advantageous position.
Here we go. Red team is going to try and shove mid as 5. This is the issue with Black Dynamite. Or, I'm sorry, with Fiddlesticks, that they haven't been grouped yet. And as you see, Irelia's top. She might be forced to teleport in to deal with the siege. They've caught
it!
Beautiful play. The Stranglethorns is dropped by accident. But that's a key player to take out. Even though the ult is down, Leona will not be able to engage in the front line. It's going to come down to someone like Kha'Zix or Irelia. And since Irelia is not here, they can't really do it. Good block on the ult. I don't know if it will be enough. It looks like this tower is going to fall.
Right.
And there's a teleport from Irelia. She's going to try and come in on back. No! And no one saw her. So she's going to walk away. Treesome, in the meantime, is way out of position. Forced to flash. Can Graves get it with the collateral damage? And he gets him.
Tristram tried to dodge it, but not nearly enough. But in the back lane, Inept is so strong.
Look,
absolutely decimating all the people.
And he just
nice doing it again.
Look at the shields, but he's going to get exploded. Meanwhile, on the back, the Wild Growth is going to save RX Yamen from W Gong's engage. And it's these even trades for both teams that are really starting to take a toll on Black Dynamite, because Black Dynamite is behind.
And Team Fiddlesticks is in a great position here to pick up Dragon on top of that. There was a failed Baron attempt by Team Black Dynamite, and right now Team Fiddlesticks will be able to grab this with absolutely no problem whatsoever, and that is their second Dragon of the game, and it's giving them some very nice benefits as they go into this mid-game.
Bonus damage towards minions so they can continue to push, and they'll have better wave clear, so they won't have to deal with any siege situations like you just saw at the mid or outer turret. Hopefully, if they get five ganked up on S5 again, they can hold off at some more turrets and deal with siege pushes a little bit better. Take a little bit of time and talk about the gold difference right now. As I was saying earlier, the gold is being put onto Inept, and the gold is being put onto You Only Legs Once. These are the two big carries for the two teams right now. Unfortunately, Inept is not getting as far ahead as he'd like to with this 4-0-3. He's not even able to catch up to Irelia, who's just been free farming in the top lane, and she's able to get all these items she really wants. She already has a Trinity Force, and she's building some more defense now.
Remember, she has 155 farm, and she's 3-1. As the result of a lane swap,
yes,
where she was facing a Zyra and a Caitlyn. To come out 3-1 and so much farm ahead, by the 20 minute mark, if you're farming within the 170 to 200 range, that's considered a professional level play right there. And she got to 150 despite being completely outranged in a 2-1 scenario. I honestly believe that WGong is playing this fantastically, and we've seen how strong his teamfights are and how strong his engages are, and that will be a great boon at the next teamfight.
Yeah, and we'll see if he ends up teleporting in again and trying to help out his team. Now, right now, his teleport is down, so if all five members of Black Dynamite decide to group up, they could probably force something to happen. But right now, it looks like both teams not really sure where to go from here. No one can really push into the other right now because they're both sort of at this weak teamfight stage. The only advantage is that Team Fiddlesticks has this amazing AoE engage they can convert on it, as we saw earlier at Dragon.
Uh-huh.
See, Treesome, I'm gonna go ahead, clean out the crab. Oh no, he's gonna clean out this ward first, then clean out the crab. Get the crab. Get the crab! He's just cleaning wards. Now they might
be- damage.
Oh, he catches him! There comes the knockup! A beautiful catch from RxJam, and he's forced to flash and heal. So he is gonna get away, but oh my goodness, that was scary for Graves.
I mean, he utilized that move speed from the heal to get away just fine, but red team is just now discovering that Dragon is missing. They were trying to group up for it, trying to make something happen, and I don't know if they might try a similar thing where they either try to catch Irelia or possibly go for a Baron push, because they know there are no wards in the area.
So they're going to sweep Baron.
Now
like
spotted by WGong.
Yeah, they're going to instead just go ahead and take this crab. Graves and Leona are all the way back at home, and Lulu is bot. Now Lulu's teleport is up, so she can come and help if she needs to, but all five members of Team Fiddlesticks are making their way over to stop this Baron attempt. Uh-oh, WGong is gonna go right in on Ninja Please. Here comes the shield. They miss the snare. WGong is so tanky. Here comes the teleport in on the plant. Looks like, uh-oh, Pew Pew is gone for RX Salmon. Beautiful Wild Growth. Inept is alive. Ninja Please is alive. Zyra has gone down. What a collateral damage. Then here comes the leap. He gets one kill, but it's just Jadimus left. One more leap, and he's trying to catch
come
up.
On, Kha'Zix,
he needs that W.
One more slow into an isolation damage. The woo damage.
There
yes,
it is.
There we go. And that was a 2-for-5 ace.
That was
in favor of Team Fiddlesticks. Their wombo combo. And oh my god, WGong aggroing the rest of Team Black Dynamite and baiting them into that fight. That fantastic command shockwave from Sergeant Crayon catching
yep.
out four members. That is how you execute deep fights. And they might, no, they're going to have to back off after this. They're playing this super safe. And while they may not be capitalizing on their winnings, they're winning consistently.
Yep.
They're 18-10, and we have not seen that this tournament yet.
Yeah, finally Team Fiddlesticks starting to turn this set around. This is the first time they've had a lead in these grand finals, and they're being incredibly cautious with what they don't want to throw. They're all backing up. It looks like purple team has actually just pinged Baron. They have the ability to do it if everyone on blue team backs up. Look at these backs. Uh-oh, pew pew. Sergeant Crayon all backing. Sick Grimes is coming in. They're just going to clean out this purple. They might actually get Sergeant Crayon. Sergeant Crayon was not able to back. The Stranglethorns goes down again but doesn't catch a knockup. This is actually critical because that was the jungler.
Yes.
Tree Stump can do as much damage as he wants, and they're going to try and take this.
And I don't think Team Fiddlesticks has a response for this. They did not back in time. They were not ready to reverse it. And this is going to be an absolutely free Baron for Team Black Dynamite, as there is no response available.
Here we go. Uh-oh, Pew Pew. Not even going to bother fighting this. This is a Baron for all of them. Now, of course, Baron buff is completely new. It doesn't give the same AP and damage benefits as Yuzu. Instead, it buffs your minions, as you're seeing right now. Cannon minion now outranges towers. That's how good this is. This is a split push tactic with Baron now. You beef up your minions and you push. Not to mention, they only have one dragon, so they don't have the two dragon power to kill as many minions as they'd like that Team Fiddlesticks has. But they have Baron to just power up all of their minions as they go.
Yeah, going off of those Baron buffs, the melee minions, look how they take half damage from turrets. Look how much tankier they are taking multiple tower shots. The cannon turrets don't just outrange turrets, they also deal four times as much damage on every auto attack.
Exactly.
They decimate in this split push build. And this makes Team Fiddlesticks have to go on the defensive during the duration of this Baron buff.
And here's the problem. It looks like purple side has no idea when dragon's gonna spawn. They tried to group up for it and get something going, but it still doesn't respond. And it responds in 20 seconds, so they've actually all backed at a prime time to try and set up for dragon. They're all gonna respawn, try and head there as soon as possible. They don't have wards directly in the camp, but they'll know if blue team tries to go for it with the crab and the pink ward.
And actually, one other benefit of having Baron buff is that your recall is actually faster.
Yeah, it's double.
Yep.
Oh, RX Yaman should not go in.
Actually, he's laying down good amounts of damage onto Kha'Zix, and he knew that Inep was not far behind. But so now you only legs once. Graves and Orianna are in no position to be ready for this dragon right now. They do not have the timer set down properly.
Yeah, and it looks like they're going to go ahead. Team Black Dynamite gonna try and take down this dragon now. Uh-oh, Pew Pew can jump the wall if he wants to. He's not going to, so the minion power is now in the hands of both teams. We're even on dragons, two apiece.
Team Fiddlesticks is losing their advantage. Team Fiddlesticks has this great momentum where they were continuously grabbing objectives, grabbing whether it was dragon or global tower, winning those team fights, and now Team Black Dynamite has picked up both their second dragon and the Baron buff. And this push is going to be insanely strong.
Oh, when he splashes the shockwave, but he caught an F, but it doesn't matter, the Stranglethorns is gonna save him. A nice splash. He dodges collateral damage, but he's gonna go down to Pew Pew. And there goes Ninja, please. Both carries are gone. Lulu did not even bother to teleport in. Pew Pew is still going. There's the ult from Nunu to try and help them escape, but W Gong is still going. Look at the damage from W Gong. He's gonna get RX Yaman, and Tree Slump is the only one left in the mid lane for red team. Lulu is just now joining the team. No teleport in sight.
9-0-8. You only like one on Graves is so incredibly powerful right now. He's able to stay in that backline without any issues. And W Gog with the extreme taken is jumping onto Tristan, just finishing up on Italy.
Oh,
is using the wild to try and get away, and he's gonna be able to get with just a little bit of health. But that is gonna be a fall on inhibitors as Inep tries to run in and do something. Oh, people falling dangerously low.
Nice
locking
defense.
The ace in the hole. Very nicely done. But by God, does Team Fiddlesticks have this great forward momentum in team fights that they're able to continuously utilize to get those picks on Nige, Please, and Inep, take them out of the fight, and then force the rest of Team Black Dynamite to have to run away and lose towers.
They have this incredible team fight comp that's just always catching Team Black Dynamite off guard. It's getting them every time. The Leona ult, the shockwave from Orianna, the collateral damage from Graves, the damage and the lockup that they keep having to deal with, they're just not getting the same utility out of things like Stranglethorns and Wild Growth and Absolute Zero. They need to be landing their ultimates to put up a fight, and they need to be stopping Kha'Zix. Kha'Zix is jumping in for absolute free. No one is stopping him ever, and that's the biggest problem in their fights right now.
And I mean, on top of that, you talked about the ultimates. The problem is that Team Black Dynamite has very close-range ultimates. Absolute Zero is directly on top of Nunu. Wild Growth has to be on the furthest champion that's the champion closest to the enemy opposing team. But Team Black Dynamite is always on the retreat in these team fights. They can't be the aggressors, so we can't lie down this, put down this absolute zero. They can't lay down the wild growth. And Karma doesn't really have an ult, she just has a modifier to the rest of her abilities. They are not being able to make up this differential.
Oh, and they might get caught out here. The Stranglethorns is going down. The Stranglethorns might have just saved, but our Xamarin has been stunned out, and he's going to go down to Kha'Zix. The jump comes out again. It's the Kha'Zix jumps that they really need to be worried about, and they have no way to deal with him. There's no CC on Kha'Zix.
W'Gong has the Trinity Force. He's playing Irelia. He's incredibly fast, but on top of that, he gets the movement speed bonus from from Orianna. And that movement speed combination lets him run up and zone or slow absolutely anyone in these fights, and that's what allows champions like Kha'Zix to be able to get those picks.
And looks like Lulu's gonna try and defend here. Kha'Zix is gonna jump right on in. He's tanking the turret. I don't know if I agree with this. The absolute zero. Nice flash. And Irelia in the back is gonna clean him up. Treesome now the only one left. Blue team can just tank towers for free as long as they want. Sergeant Crayon getting incredibly low, but still not dying. And they're going to keep this fight going. The flash from Nietzsche, please. Is it going to be enough? They're trying to put on this AoE, but it's not enough.
Oh.
Blue team is forced away. Look at the disengage. They're all so low.
Can anyone be finished off here?
No! Sergeant Crayon, no! He's gonna get away! The shockwave! Inept is actually getting super low! They're gonna turn it around! Inept is gonna go down! W'Gong is still alive! Meanwhile, the plant in the back almost took out...
Run!
almost took out Graves, was able to get Orianna. They're still chasing down
I don't know if they're gonna try and reverse this!
Spying Orb! they dropped it in the bush, but it wasn't well done. There's another ult from Leona! It's like that ult is always up! They're still chasing.
Oh, and they finally get away. You only legs once. Not being able to be taken down as he escapes with just a little tiny bit of health and manages to recover. But my god, that was a very, very close chase. Nice, actually, we're going to get
another go back in. Are you kidding me?
Oh, look my god!
And they've got him! The Stranglethorns comes through. One knockup, but it's not enough. Isn't you only legs once actually going to catch Arc Salmon? No, he's going to walk away.
Oh, just one dash away, but he chooses not to continue that fight as he doesn't know where the rest of Team Black Dynamite is. But what a great, great reversal by W'Gong. W'Gong is playing this aggression so, so perfectly.
Yeah, W'Gong, the second highest farm on the map. 6-2 and 10 on Irelia. He's unstoppable right now.
And the fact of the matter is, he's so tanky. He's got the Frozen Heart, he's got the Spirit Massage, he's got the Trinity Force. That's armor, magic resist, and health in a row. You can't stop him. He's got the Merc Treads, which give him tenacity reduction, compounded with the tenacity reduction on his passive, meaning he's literally this unstoppable force. He is better than a Malphite right now as he's able to go through these lines and dominate. And right now, Team Fiddlesticks is going to rush down this Baron, even though they do not have Graves nearby.
Yeah, this could be bad if RX Salmon is able to help out. But no, the jungler nowhere nearby. Team Fiddlesticks should get this for free. Baron starting to get low. No steal. There it is. Orianna is going to take it. And there we go. Irelia actually going in. Irelia is so big. They managed to catch out RX Salmon as well. Lulu is down. W'Gong doesn't care who you are. Oh my god!
That's one damage!
So much damage. W'Gong is just doing whatever
he
wants. RX Salmon falls as well. They're just bait for Baron buff at this point. They just want to get fed. Treesome in the back is also trying to fight. Uh-oh, pew pew. Ineth is gonna go down as well. What the shockwave just obliterated.
And a surrender!
That's it!
Team Black Dynamite goes down! And the score is now 2-1. Team Fiddlesticks with a great comeback. And we are headed into game 4 of the Capital One Circuit.
Imagine if they actually managed to bring this all the way back from a 2-0 deficit, if they bring this back all the way to 3-2. Let's check out this final score right here. I'd like to point out that Graves, realizing that he never needed a defensive item, the most defensive thing he got was Hex Drinker. There it is.
14-0-12. You only legs once completely taken away with my personal MVP. He played that solo. He has great positioning. W'Gong did so much for those fights, along with the sick rhymes and Sergeant Crayon. But I gotta hand it to you only legs once on Graves for simply the fact that he never died.
Yeah, that's impressive. At this level.